Hello guys, we are back with our next lecture. In this lecture, let us go through the next question. Okay, so this question belongs to GATE CSE 2015 Sector 2 guys. The given question is, in the context of abstract syntax trees, those are nothing but ASTs, okay, so and control flow graphs, okay, so which of the following are true? Okay, so if you recall, when do we draw these abstract syntax trees, guys? So whenever we are working with those semantic things, we work with these abstract syntax trees, right? Yes. And when do we work with these context control flow graphs? So whenever we want to understand the exact flow, like the code is running from C1 to C2, from C2 it might go to C3 or C4. So in that way, like exact flow, if you want to know, you will draw those, right? Yes. So option A says, in both AST and CFG, let node n, okay, so let me check it out, right? So it is n2 guys, okay, so node n2 be the successor of node n1. In the input program, the code corresponds to n2 is present after the code corresponding to n1. Okay, so let us go through option B. Option B says, for any input program, neither AST nor CFG will contain a cycle. Okay, so for any input program, neither, okay, means they are saying for both of them cycles should not exist. But if you recall, we have drawn many CFGs, right? So I think we have drawn two CFGs, right? So it will look always in this way, right? So C1, C2, C3, and from C3 you will come back here, and if some condition fails, you will go to end of the loop, right? Yes. So most of the programs you will write in this way only, because if you are writing a program, you always want to minimize it, right? So means you will maintain some loops to do something. You will not write a program in this way, right? So C1 to C2, C2 to C3, C2 to C4, C5 to C6, in that way you are not going to write, right? Yes. So if you write in that way also, all of them will come under C1, that's it, right? Yes. So there is a high chance that always we have a cycle, hence this option is completely wrong. And he is saying in both of them it will not exist. That's really funny, right? Yes. So now moving on to option C. Option C says, the maximum number of successor of a node in an AST and CFG depends on the input program. Okay. Option D says, each node in AST and CFG corresponds to at most one statement in the input program. Okay. So if you observe here, C2 is targeting two statements, right? So depending on the thing. So indirectly, I think I can eliminate option D also here, because it is saying at most one, means it cannot correlate with the two statements, right? Yes. Okay. So with that, I think we can say that this is a false. And even if you want, you can take in CFG format. Yes. Okay. Yes. So now we are left out with A and C. So let us recall about AST guys. Okay. Okay, so if we are having an expression in this way, like 2 into 7 plus 3, so what will be abstract syntax tree? So first I will do multiplication, and between 2 and 7, the result I will add with 3. So it's almost like parse tree only, but minimized version of parse tree, right? Yes. Okay, so now let us understand what exactly these two things they are saying. So option A says, in both AST and CFG, let N2 be the successor of node 1. Okay. N2 be the successor means N2 will be done after N1. So after N1, you will have N2. Okay. So that's what it is saying, right? Yes. Okay. They are saying in the input program. Okay. So in the input program, the code corresponds to N2 is present after the code corresponds to N1. Okay. So N2 is present after the code. So they are saying the order of the code will be in this way, right? Yes. Okay. Okay, so let us take a hypothetical case, guys. So assume that there is a go to statement or something here. So at that time, sometimes you can have the code in the reverse way also, right? Right? Yes. So assume that the flow is in this way, but in code, in reality, it is N2, N1. But here we are having a go to statement and it is pushing us to go to N1. So at that time also, you will get the arrow, but here the code is in reverse order, right? Yes. So that's a funny thing, but that's also a case, right? Yes. So that option is also wrong now, right? Yes. So now the only option which is left out is a C. So option C says, the maximum number of successors of a node in a AST and a CFG depends on the input program. So basically whatever we are having, it depends completely on the input, right? So if there is one more character here, it will take one more step, right? Yes. So in that way, everything will depend on the input thing, right? Yes. So that's what option C says. Like, that's a hypothetical truth, right? Yes. So C will be the most obvious correct answer, right? Yes. Okay. So now I hope everyone got a clear idea with respect to this question, right? Yes. So this is a type of theoretical question, right? Yes. Okay. So in the next lecture, let us continue with the next question, right? Yes. So let us meet in the next lecture. Thank you. Thanks for watching. Like, share, and subscribe for more awesome videos like this. Thank you.